In this society, we've been taught to have a stronger fear of success than we have a fear of the police system that shoots us down every single day. So what's going on, guys? It's Josiah, your success strategist. And in today's video, I want to talk to you about a very important mindset principle known as the fear of success. See, everybody knows about having a fear of failure, right? You don't want to trip and fall. You don't want to be able to do the wrong thing. You don't want to make a mistake. But very few of us actually understand that most of us are suffering from a fear of success. Do you have a fear of success? I want you to think about that in today's video, because I'm going to give you the top three indicators on how you will know that you have a fear of success when it comes to your life. So here's number one. Are you always being negative the first thought that you have when it comes to getting something accomplished? Is your first default trigger all of the reasons why something won't work? So for those of you guys that have been watching my channel for a little bit, you know that as a success strategist, every so often, I open the doors to be able to work with a new set of clients every single year. And as I open up these doors for new clients to get into my success programs, where I'm taking them step by step, showing them how to be able to start businesses, get out of debt, improve their credit, and so on, I always ask them questions pertaining to their goals. And as I am consulting one of my clients on how to be able to actually improve their finances, immediately as I'm telling them about a budget tool that they need to use to improve their finances from day to day, to manage their money so that way they could keep more money in their bank account, do you know what their first thought was? Josiah, how do I know that I'm not going to be a victim of identity theft? How do I know that my account is not going to be hacked into by using this budget program? See, we have had such a cynicism and a distrust that's been ingrained into us as a people that by default, we are always looking for all of the reasons why something can't work rather than all of the reasons why something can. See, this client didn't ask me, well, you know, okay, that sounds great. Could you tell me how I could get started? Can you tell me about how much money you think I could save from month to month by using the tool? Hey, Josiah, what are some of the top three things that I could be doing to make the most out of this budgeting account? That wasn't on their brain. Their mind was telling them, what if something goes wrong and I am in a worse position than I'm in right now? Right? That's a fear of success, because when any successful person is trying to give you the format on how to improve your life, immediately you want to think something negative. Look at how many people in the world today have access to the internet. They're getting all of this free education that was unheard of as easily as 10 years ago. You're getting better education now from the comfort of your own home than you would have had to get from the school system that you would have had to travel to in the snow. And for all of this, you know, these plush resources that are on the internet every single day, showing you how to be successful, showing you how to be great, showing you how to get out of the hood and escape poverty living, look at how many people, their first thought when they hear something like this, they say, is this a scam? Is this a pyramid scheme? Is somebody trying to make my money? We are so negative as a people that we don't realize that our negativity is the number one thing that's holding back our success. It's not anybody else. It's not the system. It's not the man. Of course, there are certain impediments. that we are facing as a people that holds us back in this life. Of course, you've got to be 10 times better than everybody else. Don't misunderstand what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, even in spite of all of those impediments, the number one most crippling impediment is the negativity of your own brain. So that's the very first sign that you need to be mindful of when it comes to having a fear of success. Here it is now. You have an opportunity to become successful. You have an opportunity to change the game. But you are so comfortable and so complacent with where you're at today, you run at the first sign of change as soon as you hear it. Like, to me, it's beyond me to how people think that there's some magic pill out in the world where it's like you don't have to change anything of who you are, but somehow your condition changes. Nothing changes unless you change it. How did I even get from being out of Los Angeles, growing up in South Central, to being where I am today as my own business owner, owning my own real estate property? I had to change. I had to shift the mindset of where I was previously. Let me go to the second point. The second way of how you will know that you have a fear of success is when you bypass a great opportunity in life to focus on mediocre things. Again, y'all know that I got the stories. I've been working with so many people over the years in my community, and I've been trying to show them the things that other communities are doing to make a fortune, all from the comfort of their own home. This is the most important time for the entrepreneur in American history, because this is arguably the most disruptive time in the world. Look at your everyday library. When was the last time that you've been to a damn library to get a book? It's unheard of. Look at how all of these major corporations are shutting down every single day. I'm looking down the street from where I'm standing at right now, and Sears is shut down because they've been disrupted. Look at the taxi system. Look at how Airbnb is replacing hotels. Look at how all of these advances in technology is shifting the economy as a whole, but yet and still, we're not shifting along with it. So as I'm working with my different clients, and I'm telling them, man, you know what? The real opportunity for you right now is not for you to go and make something that you could sell to somebody for $5 to $10. I mean, come on, man, these are small time hustles. You got people that are out here really getting it, and they're no smarter than you. They're no more talented than you. They're no more creative than you. But here you are just selling yourself short, going for what you know, and you are turning away these opportunities where I'm trying to show you how you could go from selling a $5 to $10 product to walking away with $500 every time you charge a person. Walking away every time you charge for your services, because you are a person of value. You are a person of self-worth. You have something to bring to the table, where you will have clients in this world that will pay you a large amount of money for the things that you have as a gift, man. There are certain things that you have as a gift in this life that you're taking for granted that other people would kill for, and they won't do it. For the life of me, a lot of them won't do it, man. I'm trying to help my community, but a lot of them won't do it. And the reason why I'm making this video is really not to go on a rant. It's to show you, even though the rant is kind of therapeutic, I'm not gonna lie about that, it kind of helps. The reason why I'm giving you this information is because the second type of real indicator that you have a fear of success is all about you passing up on great opportunities to chase after the mediocre. See, You don't believe in yourself enough to believe that you're someone that's deserving of being a real entrepreneur. You talk a good one about wanting to be an entrepreneur, but you really don't want to go out and take the risks. I'm up here reading books about guys like Sam Walton, the founder of Walmart. Ray A. Kroc, the guy that took McDonald's to a whole nother level. And the level of risks that these guys took to get their vision off the ground was unheard of. They worked day and night to get their vision off of the ground. And they're no better than you. And so I just want to be able to tell you, man, stop passing up on great opportunities in life because you're so damn scared. Stop going for what you know. Stop going for the same hustles that wasn't doing nothing for you 10 years ago. If it wasn't doing nothing for you 10 years ago, what makes you think that it's going to be beneficial to you 10 years later when life is more competitive now than it was 10 years ago? It's time for you to step your game up, man. Let go of that fear of success. Don't be your own worst enemy. Yes, if we have all of these odds against us, why would you be your owner's worst enemy? And you got people in society today that's ready to shoot you down, that's not willing to give you a fair trial, that's not willing to give you any justice. Why would you see all of these things happening in the world and you still come to the conclusion that, well, even though the cops are shooting me in my back, I can stab myself in the back better than they can? Stop doing that, man. Get past the fear of success. Third and final point that I want to give to you in today's video. I'm passionate about this because I love my people and I want to see us do better. The third thing that I really, really, really want you to think about when it comes to this fear of success is to stop settling for comfort and start operating off of potential. See, the reason why you like to do a lot of the things that you do is because all of those things are part of your comfort zone. Out of your comforts, it's easy for you to make the decisions that you've already made because you already know that you can do it. There's no risk in that. And because of the fact that you're not taking any risk, you're not really getting a big reward. Are you? Are you really getting a big reward when you go to work every single day? Working a job that you know that you're overqualified for, it doesn't make the most of your talents, it doesn't make the most of your gifts. 90% of you is dying away on the inside, and it's not going to get out anytime soon at the pace that you're operating. Why are you still in your comfort zone? There's nothing worth having in this life that can be achieved through comfort. Think about every great movement that's happened in this world. Was that movement accomplished through comfort, or did people have to give their life for it? See, when you even think about guys like Martin Luther King Jr., Malcolm X, Marcus Garvey, all these different figures, these were people, Jesus Christ, these were people that were willing to give up their lives in pursuit of their vision. And so if there's no risk, there's no reward. What I want you to really understand and take away from this video is, if you are still in your comfort zone in 2018 and you know that life's not getting no better for you, snap yourself out of that immediately. Let this be the video where you say to yourself, enough is enough. I've got to stop basing my life's decisions around comfort, and I'm going to start basing it around my potential. See, you're operating in 100% comfort, but you're only using 10% of your potential. You and I both know that you are so talented, there's no reason why you should ever struggle for anything a day in your life. But you struggle every single day, not because you can't do it, but because you won't do it because you're too comfortable. I want you to leave me a comment right now. Subscribe to this channel. Share this video. This is a message that needs to be heard. I'm going to ask you again, if you don't share any other video, share this video because this is a video that needs to be heard in our community. We have a fear of success that's killing us at a faster rate than AIDS in the Black community. But it's invisible so we can't see it. We'll take the best and the brightest of our own people and we'll sell them up the river because we don't want to take risk on us.